morning everyone. I am G. Sivavignan, working as assistant professor in civil engineering department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today my topic is on design of beams. Design of beams. Okay, so there are different types of design methods. First one is working stress method. Second one is plane state method. So one more method in between is alternate load method. These are the three methods used for to design. Okay, working stress method is a older method and a traditional method. Ultimate load method is after the working stress method, there is a one more method, ultimate load method. This method is a failure method. So this method is used for only 10 years. So now the modern method is limit state method. So what is meant by limit? Limit is acceptable limit of safety and serviceability of a structure before its failure. So that is known as limit state. Okay. So there are two criteria. First one is safety. Second one is serviceability. These are the two criteria should be satisfied. Okay, if you construct any RCC structure, so it should be resisted for, it should do service for 100 years. So for 100 years, we have to follow some guidelines. So it should service for 100 years. So safety is the important criteria and serviceability is also important criteria. So now the modern method is limit state method. In limit state method, okay, there are three criteria to satisfy. First one is failure safety. So failure will be bending failure, shear failure, deflection failure, torsional failure. So it should resist these four components, and here vibration, cracking, and secondary effects. Okay, these are the three criteria that should be satisfied. So for safety, they are using factor of safety. So factor of safety. So the two components are concrete and steel. Okay, for steel, the factor of safety is 1.15, and for the concrete 1.5 for limit state method. Factor of safety for limit state. So to design the beams, so we are using the limit state method. So to find out the beams, how to design, so there is an assumption. So few assumptions are made by IS 456-2000. IS 456-2000 code book. There are few assumptions. We have to follow the assumptions and we have to design the beams. Okay. So first one, so this will be the cross section of a beam. Okay, cross section of a beam, and the neutral axis will be at the center of the structure element. So neutral axis. So if we keep the any reinforcement, we will denote it by AST. AST is nothing but area of the steel. So the cross section dimensions will be B, width of the beam, capital D, depth of the P. So D will be the overall depth, B will be the width of the beam. Okay, so if we keep reinforcement here, so from the center of the reinforcement to topmost fiber, okay, the distance will be the small d. So small d is nothing but effective depth. Small d is nothing but effective depth. So there are few assumptions for the design of beams. First one is plane stress remains plane before bending and after bending. So what they are saying is okay. So is a take it as a beam. If you apply any load, it will tend to. So if you apply any load on the beam, it tends to bend. Okay. So the neutral axis also will be changes. But here, what they are saying in assumption is nothing but assuming. So assuming what they are saying is plane stress remains plane before bending and after bending. This is the first assumption. So second assumption. So the compressive strain. Strain in concrete is assumed as 0.0035. Okay, so if you take from here to here, so this is a cross section of the beam. Next, we have to take the strain diagram. So, strain diagram, if you take strain diagram, will be coming like this. Okay, strain diagram will be completely like this. The upper part is known as C. The lower part is known as P. This is the compression number, this is the tension side. Compression side, tension side. Below neutral axis, tension. Above neutral axis, compression. Okay. So, the maximum strain in compression of the topmost fiber is 0.0035. Assume it is a 0.0035. Okay, next assumption is the tensile strain. The tensile strain of the concrete is, sorry, the tensile strain of the beam is should not be less than Fi by 1.15 PS plus 0.02. Okay, this is the compression side strain, this is the tensile side strain. It should not be less than Fi by 1.15. Should not be less than Fi by 1.15 years plus 0.002. Okay, next is strain diagram. Sorry, stress diagram. So, stress diagram is will be coming like this. The fourth assumption is the shape of the compression of the tensile compressive stress will be rectangular parabola shape. So, rectangular. Rectangular parabola. This will be the 0.002. Okay, so this will be the rectangular shape, and from down below it will be the parabola. So rectangular parabola shape. Okay, so fifth assumption is the tensile stress will be ignored. Tensile stress means ignore. So the tensile stress is this part. The tensile stress will be at the tension side. So this part will be ignored. Next, sixth one. What is the best? There are only two parts remaining here in stress diagram. This is stress, this is strain. In stress diagram, the remaining part is the compression side. Okay, the compressive stress will be the 0.45 fc. Okay, how we got 0.45 fc in this? This is the stress, this is the strain for concrete. Usually the graph will be like this. This will be the fck value. Okay, so usually the partial safety factor for this concrete is, the material is 1.5. So fck is will be the 1. So 1 into fck will be fck. So if we take the divide by partial safety factor, 1 divided by 1.5, the graph will be coming like this. 1 divided by 1.5 fck will be coming 0.67 usually the concrete will be mixing by hand mix, so there will be any errors, so there will be causing of any errors, so that we have to do partial safety factor again. So again divided by 1.5, so we will get the graph as 0.45 FCK. Okay, so that's why we are taking the compressive stress of the concrete will be 0.45 FCK. Okay, so next part remaining is the tensile stress. So tensile stress, how we will get the, how we will get the tensile stress is similar stress strength for the steel. Stress strength for steel. Okay, yeah, why? So if you apply load, so there will be a resistance for high speed will be coming like this, first steel Fi. So for partial safety factor, there is an element state method. In this partial safety factor for steel is 1.15. So we have to divide the graph with here. So this will be the proof stress 0.002. Okay, so the graph will be coming from Fi to 1.15. We will get 0.87. Yeah. So this tensile stress will take by 0.87. Yeah. So these are the assumptions. By these assumptions, we will get this stress drop. Stress drop parameter is the important thing. So these six assumptions are very useful to design the beams. Okay, so next one is here, from centroid distance, from centroid distance to bottommost fiber will be the lever arm will be denoting as Z. From the lever arm, the upper part will be 0.42 xc. so how will work 0.42 xc? This is the distance between the neutral axis to upper, from neutral axis to topmost fiber of the compression fiber, it is known as XU. By equating the, by similar triangles, we will get the value as 0.42 xc as the distance between the this center to this topmost fiber. So the area of this rectangular parabola will be 0.36 xu. okay, the area of the rectangular parabola is 0.36 xu. This is the stress block parameters. To design a beam, we have to know these assumptions. After knowing these assumptions, we have to go to design part. Okay, so next, types of beams. So types of beams. So in doubly reinforced beams, the reinforcement will be at compression side, and the compression side and tension side. So these known as doubly reinforced beams. Okay, these are the two types of beams. So coming to design, so before going to design, there are few sections to discover in beams. They are financial section, over reinforced section, under reinforced sections. These are the three sections are there to discover before going to design on the beams. So for balance of section, So if you take the sustain, so if you take the stress diagram, this will be the neutral axis. So this will be the XU, depth of the neutral axis will be the XU. So balance section means where the steel and concrete will be failure at the same point. So XU equal to XU max. This is balance section. Over reinforced section. Okay. Over reinforced section. Take it as compression, you know, take it as tension. Compression concrete, tension steel. Take it as over reinforcement. You name itself, it is saying that over reinforcement. It means the reinforcement of the section is more. So it will be failure first in concrete. Okay, there are two materials, steel and concrete. If steel is more, concrete will be the failure. So concrete will be reaching the maximum strain stress from there. The strain diagram comes like this. Okay. So the failure will be like this. XU greater than XU max. Okay, this is the XU. XU will be beyond the neutral axis, so XU is greater than XU max. Next one is under reinforced section. In name itself, it is there, under reinforced section. So the failure will be first in steel. So the failure will be first will be in steel. From here it will go to like this. So the neutral axis will be here. Neutral axis will be here. It is below the neutral axis. So it will be XU less than XU max. So these are the three methods. These are the three sections we have to know before going to the design of the beams. Okay, first one is under balanced section, under reinforced section, over reinforced section. Okay, so these are the different types of beams for doing the analysis of the beams.